By the end of this video, you will know how to make a basic A-line skirt pattern from start to finish in Chloe. You can apply this pattern drafting method onto hand drafting pattern as well as onto Chloe drafting. For example, I'm going to use Chloe software to draft these skirt patterns. You will not require to know Chloe software to learn this simple drafting method. I will walk you through step by step on how to draft these A-line skirt patterns. These include measuring your body, picking the correct avatar size for your skirt, sewing it in Chloe, fitting the skirt onto the avatar, then apply the fabrics onto the skirt, all done in Chloe. Okay, so after we create this perfect skirt pattern block, next I'm going to show you how to apply the symbol onto the skirt as well as the annotation, okay? To do so, first I'm going to zoom in right here. And next I'm going to pan it over a little bit, just press down Option and Alt and left click and then kind of drag it over to the location I want it. And release. So to apply the symbol onto the skirt, I'm going to come over here to this, you see this big letter A, the second one, letter A, click on it. And I'm going to select this pattern symbol. Just click on it to select. And next, I'm going to come over here, click one on this pattern piece right here that I want to place the symbol on it. Just click on it. And as you can see, this symbol appear. However, that's not the symbol that I wanted. I want a cut on fold symbol. So to change that symbol, I'm going to come over here to this property editor panel, and I'm going to click on the twirling arrow and select this cut on fold symbol. As you can see, the symbol just changed to cut on fold. I'm going to place another symbol on this waistband, okay? Because we want to tell a customer that we want this pattern cut on fold, okay? So I'm going to click one right here to place the next symbol. And once again, I'm going to come over here to this property editor and then click on the twirling arrow right here and select cut on fold symbol. As you can see, we just apply the symbols onto the skirt. Next, I'm going to show you how to apply the annotation onto the skirt, okay? To apply the annotation, come to this symbol icon right below that letter A icon, click on it. And instead of select the symbol, this pattern symbol, I'm going to select pattern annotation. And I'm going to click one on this pattern area to place my annotation, and I'm going to type in hip line. Okay, next I want to move that hip lines tag to a little bit further over here, and to do so I'm going to need to use this right here, this edit annotation tool. Click on it. And then come over here and click on that text. You see this text box appear, and I'm going to just click and drag this text to anywhere I want it. Next, I'm going to just click one on the page to release. And if I just kind of zoom out a little bit, you see the text get a little bit bigger. If I zoom in, the text get a little bit smaller. Next, I'm going to place once again another annotation onto this waistband. To do so, I'm going to come over here to this big letter A once again, click on it and select pattern annotation. And I'm going to this time click one on the waistband, and then I'm going to type in waistband L And after that, I'm going to, again, guys, I can adjust this text only if I come over here and select on this edit symbol tool, okay? Then I'm going to come back over here, click on that tag, and this box appear. It's barely appear, like barely you can read, but you can tell right here this text box appear. I'm gonna just click and then drag, or I can also rotate that tag. You see, just hover the mouse over to that. You see that right there, that tip, and I can rotate the tag to upward, to downward, to sideways. So for this waistband, I'm going to just rotate it to like just sideways like that, okay? And once again, guys, click on the page one to release. So as you can see, we just apply the symbols as well as the annotation onto this perfect A-line skirt pattern. Next, I'm going to show you how to create copies and unfold the skirt blocks into a full skirt pattern. Okay, to do so, first I'm going to move this pattern out of the way a little bit by going to the transform tool, click on it, and I'm going to just marquee select this first pattern that we draft earlier, and I'm going to just drag over here to the top, and I'm going to just once again, guys, zoom out. Just place your two fingers onto this mouse pad and then drag it backward to zoom out. Next, I'm going to pan this pattern down by pressing down Option or Alt and left click on your page to pan it down. And to get out of this selection, I'm going to just click one on the page. Next, I'm going to move this waistband, the first pattern waistband, up over here as well. So a goal here to turn this A-line skirt block to a full pattern so we can solder onto the avatar in Clothes 3D, okay? To do so, I'm going to this transform tool, click one to select, and come back on the page. I'm going to marquee select both of these back skirt block pattern pieces, and I'm going to command or control on your keyboard plus letter C to make the copy. Then command or control on your keyboard plus letter V to paste. And as you can see, this pattern appear. I'm going to just press down shift on my keyboard and then left click to place the pattern. After that, I'm going to change this pattern block into a front pattern block.